Hi friends, how are you? I hope you had a really good start of the week and are doing very well. So friends, this channeling came about almost last afternoon and it came trickling down, till today morning, like from yesterday afternoon till today morning, it was trickling down. And I decided to receive it fully today in the morning itself, and I'm relaying it to you now in the afternoon. It is early afternoon, it is not even the start of afternoon. So what I got was, the channeling that I was getting is from the universe, and this is a talk between the universe and the divine feminine collective. Now, what the universe is trying to tell the divine feminine collective, or having a conversation, this is more like a conversation that the universe was having with the divine feminine collective. And in the conversation itself, many things are being clarified, in the form of a channeling. Quite similar to like an actual channel, but a conversation. I'm the third party, actually. I'm the third party who's hearing the conversation of the universe with the collective divine feminine. And I'm looking at it from an external viewpoint, and I don't feel that I am inside the divine feminine collective in this particular channeling. So I will just present it to you right away. So folks, the universe is actually questioning the divine feminine collective, and they are asking that who is it who actually is keeping you in a stuck position, and who is it actually, and how is it that you feel this stuckness. And they are saying that if you feel this stuckness due to a lover or due to a past lover or the divine masculine, they are saying, then they are saying you should drop him. This is the word that they are using. They are saying you should drop him, even if it means that you have to drop him for a while or for a longer while or whatever it is. They said that because your energies are stuck, unless we open your energies, they say that we cannot even receive that lover or that past lover or that divine masculine. So why to keep very held on to that energy? They are saying drop him. And by drop him, they are meaning like not to drop the person as such, but to drop the energies that you're keeping, that are keeping you stuck. Now, many of you may want to accept this or not, but when you do anything which actually chases the energy, and it could be stalking on social media, it could be thinking multiple times a day, and you have no control over your thoughts, the monkey mind takes its presence, and you have no control over it, and you're continuously thinking or thinking of things which happened between you and him, going with the karmics and all that, all that negativity or sadness, or even the positive memories, when you're thinking, or when you're finding some kind of information about him from here and there and all that, that actually is keeping your energy stuck from, and preventing you from maybe even your daily activities. All day long you're just doing this, and it might also be preventing you from other important tasks which might have to take place before the union happens. Like maybe you are supposed to clear some kind of wounds or clearings, and you are not putting effort into that. So besides the point, but the universe is saying drop him. And why the universe is saying drop him, that because they mean that if your energies are stuck because of this person, which you might accept or not, but I would urge you to accept that energies are stuck because you're continuously in his energy field. Your energy is not there available for you. I hope you understand this. So the universe is saying drop him, for that past lover. They are saying drop him for now, drop him, drop him as a person, as an energy, drop him. Then they are asking the divine feminine collective, and I'm looking at them and the divine feminine collective as the conversation is going on. They are asking that, what else is inhibiting you? Is your family really meant for you? Are they really helping you in some way? Or are they restricting you? Are they restricting your real personality? Ask yourself this question. So they are saying that, is this what you really are? They are saying no. So they are saying you have to get beyond this lover and beyond this family. That's what they are saying. For him, they are saying drop him. And for the family, they are asking you, do you really think, you know, this is going somewhere? Do you really think that these people are in alignment with you? And this includes your very immediate family, I'm sorry to say. You know, and I totally understand the dynamics, you know. So they are questioning these two people, these two ideologies in your life. One is the past lover or the lover or the twin flame or the divine lover, you know, whoever is the person. And they are saying drop him, because right now is the time to drop him to clear up your energy. Now please understand this, as long as your energy is not flowing and allowing, you cannot receive anybody, you know. So the whole point of the journey, of why you're taking this journey on a personal 3D level, is to get together with that person, besides the spiritual ascension and the you know, other good things which come with it. But basically at your human level, you're doing all this chasing and everything to get to union. And if someone tells you that you yourself are blocking your union, how would you like that, you know? So that is what is happening, because your energy is stuck. And the stuck energy, for that they are saying drop him. Now this is not going to be easy for you, but please follow, you know, follow the advice of the universe. Until you go into surrender or dropping him or clearing up your energy, he will not be able to return back. The law of attraction brings you the thing by the law of detachment. So the law of detachment paradoxically has to happen first for you to attract or magnetize that particular thing or wish or desire. Now the second thing they are asking you is about the family. You know, they are saying, are these people really in alignment with you? Are these people actually scrunching up your energy? Are these people, like, you know, all the time you're protecting your energy from your family, you know, and they're doing this or that, you know, they're always like messing up your energy, and they're shouting at you, or they're saying curse words, or they're putting their traditional beliefs or cultural beliefs on you all the time, and you are a more open-minded global person. So think about that. So what the universe is trying to tell me while holding this conversation with each one of you, you know, it is like the universe is talking to hundreds and thousands of you, and it is like a class going on, and I'm sitting on the side or outside the window and looking at all of it. That is how they are showing it to me in the film, you know. So with these, both these things, the past lover, the you know, the lover, the twin flame, and the family, they're saying, is this the real you? No, they are saying this is not the real you. So you have to get beyond this lover and beyond this family, and first you have to embrace your authenticity. And first you have to have your own authenticity, your own inner growth, you know, to be able to embrace union. Now union could be 5 days away for you, or it could be 5 months away for you, or it could be 1 year away from you. Unless you actually get out from these energies, even if the union is 5 days away, you won't be able to attract that magnet. And why that happens is because these are energetic connections, these are energetic magnetizations, you know. This is not like I met you and you met me and we texted and we met for 3 dates and then we decided to be in an exclusive relationship. It is not like that. It is not human made, it is spiritual made, it is divine made. So unless they feel that you are fit for that union, they won't give you that union, you know. They have so much power, they have so much, you know, so much effect with the energy, you know. They can trace your energy, they are the biggest psychic, you know. So let's say, you know, giving you an example, if someone would come to me saying that, you know, this is the case, and, you know, I read their energy and I find that that is not the case, so I will tell them that what, you know, modifications or what steps they need to take towards reaching the same goal, you know. But this might seem a little caustic at that moment, you know, that, you know, we thought we were close to this thing or contact or union, and she is saying that you are not, and you need to, you know, go through these steps first, you know. It might seem caustic in the beginning, but as you let the energies or the advice seep in to your skin, it takes around 1 to 2 weeks. So give yourself 1 to 2 weeks to let any channeling seep in. So any channeling or any message directly with the universe that you get, or your intuition that you get, and then you will understand that the universe or the reader was very positive for you, and they were actually guiding you towards the right path. I cannot vouch for others, but I can vouch for myself. If I tell you something, I mean it in all honest interest, I have no personal ego in anything that I do. And with the channelings that I do for all of you, you mark my words on that. You come scratch my skin if the channelings that I do don't come true in your past, present or future. You come scratch my skin. You take off my skin. You take out my skin if these don't come true. So these things are going to come true in your past, have already come true, going to come true in your present, or going to come true in your future. So this particular channeling is about the universe talking with the feminine and asking her to drop him. Secondly, asking her to actually figure out the family situation, and if it is not meant to be, either move out physically or move out emotionally and detach from the people living in the same house. You can live in the same house, in the same apartment, but you can emotionally detach from them. That is a little harder to do, but the physical distance that you create from them is also not very, it is not going to make a difference. Now, I will explain this more. When you move out from your family home and you start living on your own, there are many other physical things that you have to cater to, like materialistically, you know. But when you stay in the same house and you emotionally detach yourself, you have this, those things, you know, those material things, but you do not let their energy affect you to a very deeper level, you know, to a very deep, hardcore level, you know. And that you have to train yourself every day, you know. It is not, it doesn't happen in one day. It is like, you teach a child to drive a bicycle, or you teach a child to brush his teeth. It happens like that. So don't beat yourself up. But these two things have to happen. That, and also I will tell you that moving out physically and staying in the same place and moving out emotionally are actually similar things, and they take equal effort. So don't think that only moving out physically will do the deal. You know, if for any reasons you cannot move out physically right now due to materialism, due to finances, or due to anything, you know, your children are small or whatever, you detach emotionally. The whole point is that we have to get our energy back, and the divine feminine at this point, I will also tell you that you have become very powerful and empowered, because I will tell you also why. You had your energy in different areas. You had your energy put in different areas. One area was your family, one area was your masculine twin, one area was your sister, one area was your sister-in-law's family, one area was the ex-lover who was harassing you all the time. So you had your energy, because you're such a giving, nurturing and loving person, you had your energy in all these areas. Now as you have grown wiser and the click has happened, you know, in one of my channelings I told, a click has happened suddenly, a sudden epiphany has happened, and you have just understood everything, that you know how you were scattering your energy all around and those people were doing nothing for you. And by doing nothing, I don't mean physically doing nothing for you. Energetically they were doing nothing for you. They were just giving you bad energy over and over again, and you were stuck in that victimization cycle. And now a sudden click, a sudden epiphany has freed you. There's so much freedom, power and empowerment. That is why the universe is now talking to you to even drop him. This is the next step. Drop him. Drop the family emotionally. Drop him also emotionally. Disconnect. You know, with the disconnection, you will further increase your power, further increase your inner strength. You will further empower yourself. And once you are in high vibration, then all of the things external to you will start setting to get right, you know. That is how the union will also come, you know. That is how other things, a good job and improved family relations or improved sister-in-law or improved sister will also come, you know. So, folks, I hope you found this channeling very valuable and you will get valuable information about this. And remember that your masculine union or anything else that you desire, and specifically your masculine union, I don't have any qualms about saying that, you know. I don't have any qualms if you want a 3D union, you know, so be it. But that has to come through a process and through various steps, you know. So I hope you found this valuable, and for all personal readings, you have to go to the description box, use the PayPal to pay, and then send me your story in 300 to 500 words on my email. These are the two steps that you need to take to get a personal reading. And also look for inner work list and look for inner work services that you so highly need. And all of the inner work services are also listed below the personal readings for you, and you can buy any of them, or you can get an inner work list from me to know that what all you need to do and then proceed ahead, you know. So that is the process streamlined for you. Bye bye, my friends. Many kisses.